Hello everyone, welcome to Practical BIM. So I want to share to you an interesting workaround regarding loadable families. So if you are using Revit when creating project BIM model, most of us know that there are some limitations on creating customized families. So when it comes to BIM model auditing, basically our goal is to make our project Revit BIM model consistent, so it would be easy for us when we need to extract data or information. So how we will do it? So by making sure that all building elements should be on the correct Revit categories. So as the project progresses, there will be additional details or geometries required in the BIM model, right? So comparing the construction or fabrication model to the design model, there will be additional elements and details required in the construction model. To give you an example, ceiling systems. So there will be ceiling hangers and subframes that we need to create or to model. So for raised floor, there will be floor pedestals and subframes. So how do we create those elements? So we create a customized loadable Revit family. So for example, I want to create a new family. I just need to go here on the file, new family, metric generic model. And if you go here on the create tab and family category and parameters. So these are the list of the family category. So have you noticed that the examples I provided, such as ceilings, floors, and even walls, are not available in the family category list? So if I created additional details for ceiling, wall, and floor system, on which Revit category will I use? So normally, we use either generic models or specialty equipment. Then, under the generic model category or specialty equipment category, we will just create a subcategories. For example, we are creating floor pedestals. Okay. So for us to easily manipulate the visibility of that particular elements when we are working in Revit project. But as I've said earlier, as much as possible, what we want is to make that all building elements are on the correct Revit categories. So if we want to extract or generate schedules or quantities, I could extract the data by only having one schedule for that particular system. So in this example Revit project, I have created a 3D model ceiling system containing ceiling panels, subframes, and hanger rods. So it's like this. So all of these families are loadable families. So what's the difference with normal loadable families from these families that I have created? So the difference is the category is under the ceiling category that does not exist in the family category list in the loadable family editor. So even though it's in the ceiling category, if I click edit family, I already forced Revit to make it as a ceiling category even though it does not exist here in the family category and parameters. Okay, so you will notice it's under ceiling category. Okay. So, What's the benefit of having the components on the same categories? So the benefit is, if I go on the visibility graphics, I could easily control the visibility or filter it according to its correct category. So if I hide the ceiling category, all my ceiling systems will be hidden. Or if I just hide ceiling hanger rods, I could just hide ceiling hanger rods, ceiling panels, ceiling subframes. So it will be easy for me to manipulate the visibility. Other than that, is I could extract all the data or information from the ceiling system with only one schedule, by generating only one schedule for this. Okay, so if you will see here on the ceiling material schedules, all of these elements are actually here. And I could just easily add parameters I needed on the ceiling material schedule. Okay. So the question is, how did I do that? So this is the workaround. So by using the Inplace component and save it as a Revit family. So if we go on the component, Inplace component or model Inplace, so all the missing family category that does not exist on the loadable Revit family are actually available here. So you will see there's the ceilings, floors, walls, topography, and roofs. So our plan is to create a Revit family having walls, ceilings, floors, roofs, and topography category that we could use as a template. So whenever we want to create loadable families for those categories, we just have to copy the template and rename it to the correct family name. So how we will do that? So the first thing that we need to do is, let's just have to create a new project. Let's just use the default construction template of Revit. Okay. So what we need to do is go on the any of these elevations and just delete the levels except level 1. So level 1 will be our reference level. So we don't need the site view. We do not need this one. Okay. Then what we need to do is to locate the origin of the project. So the origin of the project is the location of the project base point or the survey point. Okay, here. So the next thing that we need to do is click on the model on the architecture tab, on the re-architecture tab, component, model in place. For example, we will be creating a ceiling family, right? Ceiling family in place component. Click ceilings, ceiling 1. And we will create a simple geometry. So this family will have its 3D component. So this will be used as a placeholder only. Okay, click OK. So once the 3D component is created, click this while inside the Revit, the Inplace Family Editor, Inplace Family Editor, click the 3D component and click create group. Okay, So group 1. And the next thing that we need to do is go on the project browser, groups, folder, right click, save group. So locate where you want to save the family template. So since we've choose ceiling category, so we'll just rename it as ceiling family template. So you will notice that the file subtype would be on the Revit family or the .rfa format. So this is the format that we need to create what we want. Okay. So it will be saved. Then the next thing that we need to do is if we want to create another one, for example, floors. So we'll just go on the family category and parameters again, change it to floors. So your family is already in floor category, right? Then just go again on groups folder, save group. So rename it to floors. Save. Then we could just do it for other categories such as walls, roofs, and topography. Okay, so I don't need this one. I'll just close. And what I will do is I will just click open, go to the family, go to the location where we saved the template, the RFA template, ceiling family template. And everything is already here. So I don't need this level one. I just need the floor plan. And delete the simple geometry that we've created. Then just click save. And we'll do it the same with the floor family template that we've created. So just delete this. Okay. Then just save. And that's it. So if we want to create, for example, a ceiling hanger rod for the ceiling systems, so what I will do is I will just open the family, go to where the family template is, and just copy, paste, and rename it to the correct family name that we need to create, ceiling hanger rods. Okay, click open. So we're already here at the ceiling hanger rod.rfa. Then you will notice that the category is already in ceiling category. If you will go on the objects task, it's ceiling. If you go on the visibility graphics, it's ceiling categories. So we could now create a new subcategory for ceiling hanger rod. Let's just try to create a simple geometry. So let's just put here like 6 mm diameter, like this, click OK, change this to subcategory, ceiling hanger rod, and load it into the project. So if I go on the component, so to show you the ceiling hanger rod one, and just put it on the location you want. Then you could already adjust the height, the offset. Okay. You could put any level you want. So that's the good thing with the loadable families. Then if you go on the visibility graphics, you could just hide it, then everything will be hidden. And that's it. So I hope that you've learned something in this video, and hoping that you could use it on your current or future projects. So thank you and have a nice day.